Hi, I'm Claire Desjardins. I'm a Canadian abstract painter, and today I'm going to show you how to use acrylic polymers by Lipitex.
First things first, what I like to do, so that I know what I'm reaching for very quickly, I like to prepare all my paints by putting a little dab of paint color onto the lid so that I can see them when I'm looking down at them. So I'm gonna take the inside of the seal and just go like this, you see, voila, I can easily see the color of the paint from the top. And I'm going to do that with each of my colors. And I'm gonna go rinse my hands.
I forgot to put gloves on. I'll do that now.
There. Here we go.
These are the products I'm going to work with to create a textured and colorful painting. The first product I'm going to show you is crackle paste, so I'll need a good palette and a palette knife.
I'm going to start with my Liquitex crackle paste. So here I will take a scoop of my crackle paste. As you can see, it's quite thick. It's like a really nice custard, or almost like a butter. So I'm going to use my palette, put that there. Now let's try the Prussian blue hue. I love that color. So I'm going to squeeze a dab of that on there, and then I will mix it in. And I'm going to apply it with my palette knife. Let's see. I'm going to just apply it right here. Okay, nice and thick. So you can see what happens. And so I'm doing a nice smooth area.
So here you go. Just want you to have a look at how smooth and thick it is. It's really a paste. Can you see if I hold it this way? Can you see how if I pull it out, it gives it like ridges? But I'm gonna actually just keep it kind of smooth, a little bit of ridges. Okay, and we're gonna see how that dries. The crackle paste, Liquitex crackle paste. The next product I'm going to show you is called satin gel. And this is also a paste, as you can see. Look at that lovely thick texture. I will take a dollop of this, not quite as thick as the crackling paste, but it's still very thick. Okay, and what this is going to do, it will create ridges. So let's pick a color for this. How about turquoise? So I'll just squirt a little bit of turquoise onto and mix it. Again, I will make an attempt. Keep it in one place as much as possible. And I will apply it with my spatula. I'm gonna put it right next to the blue, because I think it would be interesting to show how the textures are different when they're next to each other. That is the satin gel by Liquitex. I will hold this up so you can have a look at the two mediums that I've mixed together. This one is the crackle paste. It hasn't started to crackle just yet. It needs to dry. And this one is the satin gel. So for this one, I'm going to use my trusty old paintbrush. I will use a little pot in which to mix my containers. I like white because then I can really see the color. I can see how transparent it is. So I'll put a little bit, not too much. What this will do is it will extend the color. So I will take a color and how about I go with the pink. I do love a good fluorescent pink. I'm going to use this one. Okay, I will mix it with my brush. So here we go. And then it'll make the paint a little more transparent. They call that extending the paint because it makes it go further. Next up, I'm going to show you both the silver and the gold metallic medium. So these just give a metallic effect to the paint that you add them to, so whether it's the silver or the gold. We'll start with the gold metallic. Okay, so I'm going to take my paintbrush to begin with. I'm going to show you just what this looks like all on its own. So here's what it looks like all by itself. You see it's quite translucent. But I'm also going to do something else. I'm going to mix it with a color. So here, it's really hard to see. Next up is the silver metallic. I'm gonna give it a good shake. I'm gonna use this paint in the lid. And I'm gonna put that right next to the gold so you can see the difference. This color, oops, is called light blue violet, and it's gorgeous. I am going to paint some yellow because I think I need some yellow in my painting. The nice thing about painting is that you can change your mind halfway through something. And I think I'm going to cover this before I start working with the masking fluid, because what I want to do with the masking fluid is paint on the areas that I would like to keep whatever color it is underneath, then do a wash, and then remove the masking fluid so that you can see what those areas are that were underneath. As it's drying, you can see the crackling is starting to happen as the paint dries in the sun. I put it outside just to speed things up a little bit. The gold, where it's mixed with the pyrrole orange, is a beautiful pumpkin color. And the silver is a little more subtle, but it's definitely there. My painting had some time to dry. I put it outside in the sunshine, and I wanted it to dry so that I could show you some close-ups. Here's the crackling paste. Okay, you can see what happened is that the paint dried a little bit lighter. It's a really beautiful blue jean blue now. And you can see it looks like the Sahara Desert. Okay, it's got crackles in it. This here is the satin gel. It is almost dry. The surface is dry, dried a touch, but in the thicker parts, it would probably need an extra day or so. Metallic, gold metallic. Here is the gold metallic mixed in with my pyrrole orange. So you can see the streaks of the gold. And here it's a really pretty kind of almost peach color. It has a little shimmer to it. Just like here has a shimmer to it, but this has a silver shimmer to it because I use the silver metallic. Next up, I'm going to use something that I have not used before. It is masking fluid. I am going to give it a good shake. I'm going to paint over areas. It's a lot like batik. You paint over the areas that you want to keep a certain color. So I love this. I'm driving down an empty freeway. No way. I'm going to put it under a fan so that we can get this area to dry more quickly. I'm seeing My masking fluid is dry and you don't see it. Unless you hold it in the light where you can maybe see it sheen, like it glistens a little bit. You see the lines that I painted over the yellow. So what I'm going to do now is take a little bit of clear gesso, which I like sometimes to paint over paint. Right now, if I were to put wash onto thick acrylic paint, which I've got underneath the masking medium, it might bead up. So I'm being very careful. I'm taking a paintbrush. I probably should have just done a layer of this first, but I didn't. So I'm taking a paintbrush and I am painting on some clear gesso just in the spots where the paint is exposed. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put a fan on it and let it dry. And when it's dry, I'm going to put a wash hot pink over the top to see what I get. So I'm trying very hard to avoid the areas that I painted with the masking fluid. So we'll see what happens. Maybe this will work, maybe it won't. I have to redo the video. Also, put some masking fluid this way. Both the masking fluid and the gesso, the clear gesso, have dried. So now I am going to try painting a little wash over it. You can hear the grit. Hear that? That's where the gesso is. And here it's kind of tacky, kind of sticks to my latex glove. That's where the masking fluid is. Okay, so the next step that I'm going to do is some hot pink that I mixed with satin medium. So the satin medium, again, it extends the paint, it thins it out. We're adding a little bit of water to it. And I'm gonna grab a paintbrush. I'm gonna mix this all together. So basically this mixture is the same as this pink swirl, except that I've added more water to it, okay? And I'll do a little bit more. I don't know if this is gonna work or not. That's part of the fun. I will add a little bit of, which color shall I add? A bit of white into this. Just a little bit. A little bit goes a long way. And I'm also gonna add a little bit more water. I like to spray my water in, especially when I'm trying to control how much goes in, because that way it doesn't flood my paint with too much water. And maybe just to have a little color variation, let's add, maybe I'll add some of this here, which is cadmium free red light. Quite a bit of it, actually. Sometimes that happens, doesn't it? And you can see the color is very pretty. It's like a tomato. Reminds me of cream of tomato soup, actually. I am gonna add more water. I just wanna wash on it. I want it to be somewhat transparent. So my wash is dried. Okay, so I've put a wash all around this area and here and under here and here and a little bit of here is where I use the masking fluid. So I am going to use my bare fingers to rub off the masking fluid. It sort of reminds me of rubber cement glue. Ooh, look at that. I love that. Already I love it.
pretty sweet too. There you go. Look how easily that comes off. Just a little bit of rubbing with my finger. And really, it is like rubber cement glue. That's what it feels like.
I'm driving down an empty freeway. No waiting for the light to change. I'm seeing the sunrise behind me.